say we need to get nearer to our Heavenly Father. And then we are right now. Maybe it's 3-4-0 for the next election. It's even 3-4-0. I know whom I have believed of. Do you know who you believe in this? Sing before we don't sing them. And that's to remember how they go, but we're doing the best we can with what we got to work with, so to speak, and let the Lord get the blessing out of what we do here in this house this evening. Page 235 for the next, this is a little bit easier.
Thank you.
seen. We got another song, anybody want to sing? I feel like singing one more before we fellowship.
114.
114. We'll try that, sis. Page 114.
Thank you. That's the only way to get this now.
Thank you.
say we got four meetings. We thank Mr. Jan for those songs, for Tommy and for helping the land course. We hope and pray. We're thankful for Jesus this evening. Maybe you've got a testimony that you'd like to offer to the service. Anything to talk about? God been good to anybody down through this day?
Yeah, Brother Charlie, I was sitting here with you and talking about being free. You look down through the ages of the Bible, biblical times and stuff. Every time somebody got set free, it cost somebody's life.
Yeah.
You can go to where, you know, the gladiators and stuff, when they fought to get the freedom, somebody had to die. When the slave was set free, somebody had to die. When we were saved from our sins, somebody had to die.
Yes, amen.
Our men and women today are still fighting for freedom that we have today. I'm so thankful, though, that I got a Savior that he just didn't die and said, that's the end of the story, right?
Yeah,
you know, he said it's the right hand of the Father. He overcame death that we might have eternal life.
Amen.
I thank you tonight for that promise that once you're dead, it's not the end of the story.
Amen.
There's more to
it. Praise God.
There's a heavenly game. Thank God for that.
Amen. Someone else. I certainly enjoy the testimonies from God's people. Someone else is here. Anybody else?
Charlie, I
want to
thank the Lord tonight. I thank whoever wanted to pray this morning for me because I'm here tonight.
Yeah.
I don't think I've made it if my wife was this morning. But I thank God that he answered prayer.
Amen.
I thank everybody in here.
Amen.
Bless you, Jim. We're glad so glad to get you back in God's house this evening. We know you won't be here. I know you won't be in God's house when you can. Physical ailments and all that, but sometimes we can't. We got to use good common sense most of all. And if you got any common sense, you ain't like me, but that's all right too. Someone else to see the testimony. Someone else. If not, I'll ask our ushers to come. Go ahead, Brother Don.
Charlie will say, thank the Lord for another beautiful day to give us.
Amen, brother.
In his house one more time.
Bless you, brother. Amen. God certainly has been good to us down through this day. Our Heavenly Father, God, as we gather together this evening, God, we'll thank you and praise you, God, for the goodness of this day. We are so blessed, God, and we just want to say thank you, Lord, from the bottom of our heart for what you've done for us. God, you bless us down through this week. You give us food on our table, shoes on our feet, and roof on our head, God, and we just thank you and praise you. Now, Lord, as we lift this evening up, we're thanking you, God, for those that will give the offering this evening for the upbuilding of thy kingdom. We'll watch over and care for us. We'll praise you, God, in your name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
appreciate that song this evening. Speaking of songs, we had some beautiful songs sung to us this morning, didn't we? I certainly enjoyed the song service this morning, but this is another service. Yeah. God has made put a song on your heart this evening that you would like to sing to the congregation this evening. So any one of the songs this evening.
I haven't heard about George if you remember or not, but Brother Gary, I'm getting my thing. Anyhow, he's an elderly man, but all his life he did not accept Jesus Christ as personal Savior. When he got down pretty bad, then he called upon God, and God saved him. And he was prayed for him. He was very faithful. It was about every Sunday, perhaps, by his prayer meeting. If we were either discouraged, we got encouraged when we left. Because his prayer was, he said, I don't pray that God will heal me. But he said, I wasted all these years without serving God. So I don't feel worthy for God to heal me. But you know what? He blessed everybody else. When we go there to lift him up, we're the ones that got blessed. So I thank God for the past life, the things I've seen. I thought many years ago we went to a nursing home service over in Waverly. And once we listened to this, and every Sunday morning, every Sunday afternoon we would go in there, one elderly gentleman would get by the scene, start walking back to the alleyway, cursing and everything. We don't need this foolishness. But you know, church, I was up there Sunday, and Brother Junior remembers, I just turned service toward him to preach the gospel. And nurse came out and got me, said there was an elderly gentleman back there wants to have prayer. And I didn't know who it was, and got back to the room, who it was, that old man that did that. And again, I never want to go through this experience again with George. And I thought I'd begin to pray, and my prayer just felt real wet. We didn't even go up as high as a ceiling. And I prayed, and I sought the face of God, but God said no. So I went along back out there and into the part of the service, and Brother Jerry just finishing up. And after he finished up, I put him back in the room and came back there with that prayer. I didn't tell you who it was. Went back to the room, and again, we tried to pray again. And I didn't say anything to him about how far my prayer went before. And he said, I can't pray. And I think sometimes we can wait too long before we seek the face of God. God will just church order great mind, and he began. So I feel like they want that man. So we finally said, God, if you're not going to save you, that one healing just takes one out of his own life. So I have the Holy Spirit who went out eternity lost without God. Amen.
Bless you, Lord. Some of the song. Angie's going to come and sing for you. But she's coming, you may want to testify this evening.
You know, sometimes it's hard to keep a human out of the church.
Amen.
You know, it's really, really hard to be the kind of Christian that you need to be. And I struggle every day. Yeah, I'm not perfect, I'm not just close to perfect, you know, but with the grace of God and just continue to walk with my Lord, I'll be closer to perfect.
After I tell this story, I'm going to say, George preached this morning about the wife that comes to church without their husband, and you know, I did that for 12 years. Pastor Gary preached a sermon on putting them on your palate, not the men that lower you through the roof to Jesus.
Yeah.
So I thought, I'm putting them on my palate.
Yeah, glory.
And he come home early.
our Lord works. And I said, oh, Lord, I didn't know what you were going to send, but the Lord did.
Yeah, amen.
The Lord do what we're going to pray about before we ever open our mouth. Aren't you glad for Jesus? Somebody was talking about cold chills this morning. Was it you, Brother George? I'm getting those cold bumps right now. I thank the Lord for them cold bumps.
Yeah.
Glory,
yeah.
Glory bumps.
Glory bumps. Whatever you want to call them. They're chill bumps to me, but the Bible glory bumps too. But anyhow, we're thankful for Jesus to sing. Come on, Jan, sing for us.
While we was going to the choir, she was playing the birthday song. So that's what we're going to do. Everybody, get your name, you stand up, okay? Outside and I talked to my sister-in-law on the phone and she said, did you drop?
And even though I was lost, I was still happy.
Yeah.
Because I knew he was going to die. And like I said, it was just a couple months before he died. And I went in the house and I said, why didn't you tell me? He said, I was going to tell you in my own time. He looked at me and said, now it's your turn.
Yeah.
And it took me several years to even go to church because I got so mad at God for taking me up because he was only 44. But when I finally did, Marcus said, honey, go to church with me, go to church with me. I knew what would happen. And she's why I kept telling him, Mom, I don't want to go. Mom, I don't want to go. And then I'm so glad that night in that revival that I'm in. I've had a lot of struggles since then, or different things. You know, we all have our troubles and trials. I'm just glad you know that I can always go to God. You know, no matter what happens. A lot of people have told me that you can imagine the big change that was in me when I got saved. A lot of people that knows me now that didn't know me back then didn't know that I was the type of person. I mean, no matter what anybody said to me, I was ready to jump. I was ready to snap. I didn't care who he was. And I keep telling Bob, you know, Bob, you know, says his brother, you know, committed suicide. He's feeling, you know, harsh towards people. I said, Bob, you know, just gotta let go. You know, he made that decision to do that and not turn to God. You know, just let it go. You can't be harsh towards that. You know, that's not God-like. And he's trying. He really is. He don't say the harsh things that he used to say and stuff. You know, I'm just so blessed that, you know, I went that night and got saved. And Rory was there and the church was comfortable. I couldn't tell you who preached that night. Because after I got saved, I didn't care who preached.
Yeah.
They just prayed for me.
Yes, it's right. Okay.